Howdy everyone, Mr. CAUSEY here with another problem of the week, and this week we're going to look at ionic compounds and how to name them. So let's get started. How would you name the following compounds? And we have six ionic compounds. And now I know they're ionic because it's a metal and a nonmetal. So that makes them all ionic. And the thing we need to remember about ionic compounds, it's a metal and a nonmetal. So let's get out our periodic table and take a look at the periodic table here. If you look at boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, tellurium, polonium, and astatine, these are the semi-metals or metalloids, and they kind of separate the non-metals from the metals. To the left of them, you are more metallic, and to the right of them, you are less metallic. So you've got to get out your periodic table, and you've got to use it. It's one of your most important tools, people. You also might want to download this handout right here that I have at yourchemcoach.com. Go down to the URL at the bottom of the page. Just put that into your browser. Go and download this handout. It's on roots and prefixes. It has the most common polyatomic ions on it as well. It's a great sheet to have. And boy, I tell you, if you could talk your teacher into letting you use that, or at least use it as a way to memorize all of this information, it's a great tool. One of the first things you want to do is write the name of the cation. And that's usually the first element, and it's the metal. Then you want to take the root of the anion and add IDE. Just like oxygen, the root is ox, so add IDE and you have oxide. Then three, check the charge of the metals. You always want to make sure you check the charges and everything's going to balance out, especially those metals that have multiple ions. They have multiple charges, like chromium. You have chromium plus one, and you have chromium plus three, and chromium plus six. And so you have to know which ion you're talking about and balance it. And also it's where we use our Roman numerals. And use your polyatomic ion sheet. Now, the way we name these ionic compounds is different than the way we name a covalent compound. It takes a little more thinking because you've got to be sure whether or not you're going to be using a Roman numeral or one of the old names. Now, I say that you learn the new system, but you be aware of the old system. It's on the handout if you download it, those that have the old system names. All right, let's get going. To the magic blackboard, sodium chloride. Well, first of all, it's sodium. And then notice we have a chlorine ion. And by the way, sodium is plus one, chlorine is negative one. And if you don't know how to do charges, you need to go and find my video on valence electrons and Lewis dot symbols and the one on oxidation numbers and learn about how to figure out the charges. But sodium is plus one, chlorine is negative one, it balances, so we have sodium chloride, and you notice we add the IDE. Pretty simple and straightforward. Let's look at the next one, CSI, cesium, and then we have the I, which is iodide. Pretty straightforward. And both charges, cesium is a plus one and iodine is a negative one, so they balance out, we're good. Calcium carbide. Well, we have calcium, and calcium has a plus two charge, so you notice we have two carbons there, and that's good. But calcium does not have more than one ion, so we don't need to use Roman numerals. Just write down carbide. And remember, don't use numerical prefixes with ionic compounds. That's reserved for molecular or covalent compounds. BaCO3, barium. And CO3 is a polyatomic ion, so I look on my chart there, and it's carbonate. Barium carbonate. And you need to be aware of and to recognize polyatomic ions. CaO, calcium oxide. Calcium is a plus two, oxygen is a minus two, so it balances out real nice, and there are no worries about the ions. Calcium has one type of ion, copper and chlorine. Now, apparently, there's two Cls there. There's two chlorines, and so then we would say copper chloride. Most people would, but that's just not correct. And the reason that's not correct is because that's copper 2. I know it's copper 2 because the chlorine. Notice the chlorine right here has two ions, And chlorine is a negative charge. So that's a negative 2 over here. That means this is plus 2 because they have to balance. And copper can be copper 1 or copper 2. And in this case, it's copper 2 because of the charges. So then I would write copper 2 chloride. And that's how we do it. Send an email to Mr. Causey at mrcausey.com. And check out Mr. Causey's world. There are videos and PowerPoints and much, much more. Also, subscribe to my YouTube. Yeah. Studies have shown that it increases your IQ. Happy Irons, everybody.